these are the Black Mountains of Wales. And it was here that Professor Walker discovered the stress effect that causes daffodils that are grown here to produce much more galanthamine than daffodils grown anywhere else. So we start from a countryside like this and end up with a white powder which goes into tablets to benefit Alzheimer sufferers.
Alzheimer's disease is the most common form of dementia in people over 65. According to Alzheimer's Research UK, the disease affects around 6 in every 10 people, and this figure is set to rise.
When my family and I discovered my wife, she was suffering from this disease, it wasn't obvious at the start. These things start from very small beginnings, and the children noticed that their mother wasn't quite remembering where everything was and went to see a doctor, and they diagnosed her as probably suffering from early onset Alzheimer's. Coincidentally, at this time, I went to a reunion with a lot of my old friends who'd worked in plant research and plant science. And one of the people there was Professor Trevor Walker, who had already started to consider the whole question of treating Alzheimer's through a compound processed from daffodils. And when I told him the story, he was very affected, and it was really the trigger for us to get together and work.
Through past research working in Bulgaria, Professor Trevor Walker had come across wild flowers that for years had been harvested to produce galanthamine, the chemical extract that slows down the progress of Alzheimer's. Alzheimer's causes an enzyme imbalance in the brain, whereas galanthamine, once in the body, creates the opposite enzyme imbalance in the brain. So getting the dosage of galanthamine right is key to restoring the equilibrium. Whilst the wildflowers of Bulgaria are not common in the UK, there is one flower that grows aplenty across our nation and is also known for producing galanthamine. That flower is the daffodil. However, not all daffodils are created equal.
This old variety, because it produces a lot of defensive enzymes which can be used, it tends to produce more of these defensive enzymes if it's put under stress. So, in other words, if you put this old variety in beautiful, easy conditions in Lincolnshire, it won't produce much of this product. But if you put it under stress on mountainsides, it'll be a much weaker plant, but because it has to defend itself, it will produce more of the protective product that we're looking for. So it became a question of searching for the ideal stress to put the plant under.
After years of kitchen table, garden shed research, the professor's search led him to discover the Black Mountain effect, whereby daffodils growing under the special conditions of the Black Mountains of Wales produce much more galanthamine than they would anywhere else.
It was at this point that I met Professor Walker, because the next step from there was to work out how to exploit this discovery and develop a commercial agricultural crop. And my background as a farmer fed into that.
Drawn by the professor's journey to help his friend and the opportunity to create extra jobs for the local community, Kevin Stevens, a local farmer, contacted the professor to offer his help in driving the project forward.
So we then set out to invent, discover, develop how to make that discovery a commercial reality, and thereby both Mrs. Palmer, but the ever-increasing population of Alzheimer's sufferers worldwide.
Together, the professor and Kevin embarked on a journey that would not only lead them to create a new way of planting, but also to create equipment unique to this type of operation.
Well, we started off with the concept that daffodils grown on top of the mountains had more galanthamine, but then we had to reinvent the process for planting them, growing them, harvesting them, and onward processing. With this project, Harper Adams and ourselves invented a machine that, to all intents and purposes, unzips the pasture, puts the daffodil bulbs in, and then zips it back up. So the disturbance to the soil is minimal, and it doesn't have any impact in any real terms in terms of grazing the sheep?
So these are the labs where we process the juice that we've extracted from the daffodils in the field. And behind me we've got the concentration step, which allows us to take it from dilute juice through to concentrated juice, which we then isolate into its components. We deal with tons of daffodil juice per day. At the moment we're only running the small evaporator, as we're doing a trial run, but we have big equipment that will handle tons.
Galanthamine is very constrained on the world market. It's currently selling at around about $20,000 per kilo. It's actually more expensive than gold. So in essence, our project, we're trying to turn the Black Mountains golden.
With a working process in place to produce significant quantities of galanthamine in its purest and most affordable form, the professor and Kevin look to expand the business to meet the demand of the ever-increasing Alzheimer's population worldwide.
We can get more chemical off each acre, then clearly we've got a better process. And this is where the money is going to come from, is being able to be competitive and produce this substance at a lower cost than anyone else. We should work just as well in other parts of the world. Indeed, we are exploring growing daffodils in New Zealand as well as in South America. Because it is absolutely important for us to have a source of supply from the southern hemisphere. The key pharma markets are UK and Europe, Japan and North America. And we would envisage having a presence in all of those markets.
If one can produce these products naturally, in particular the galanthamine for Alzheimer's, then because it's natural, it's not officially a drug. And one could imagine a future where small quantities would be helpful for the worried well. In other words, as a preventative to stop Alzheimer's happening at all in the first place.
As it happens, the team has now partnered with a Canadian company following a growing demand for their product.
Our desire is to provide folks with an affordable, effective way to help their brains age in a healthy fashion.
As the team continues to explore the capabilities of the daffodil, they have found that there's more than meets the eye with this modest little flower.
The delight is that the daffodil is a little chemical factory. It has at least 10 important chemicals that it produces. Galanthamine is only one of them. We've also got the ability to extract these other chemicals as well. So this really opens up the market for us.
There are other products that are able to be extracted, which has a potential of dealing with brain cancer. The glioma, Cardiff University is working on being able to use this compound to be able to treat that up to now almost untreatable cancer.
One of these chemicals will switch off the cow's ability to generate methane. Quite incredible. How did this all this happen? You know, why did the daffodil go and decide to make these chemicals?
Nature's mysteries may never be fully understood. However, what started with a man's drive to help his friend's wife has created a game changer for the future of the world's Alzheimer's population and their loved ones.
All drugs of this kind, you know, it's just too expensive to develop them for one country. You've got to go global if you have treatment like this, and that's our ambition.
My wife knew that we were working in this area. She naturally encouraged us because this was an attempt to improve, if not for her, the future for other people who would suffer from this horrible disease.
I think we've now reached the point at which we can practically offer hope to those people in that we will be producing enough galanthamine to make a difference. Thank you.